Now, let's look at one more example. And this time, we go to a bank and hope to get a fair coin, this golden coin over here. And our alternate hypothesis is a two-sided hypothesis. The probability either is smaller than 0.5 or larger than 0.5, which we write as p unequals 0.5. And the way to look at this conceptually, in all we've done so far, we assumed that H0 is correct. We'd computed some sort of distribution, and then we carved out a critical region such that the volume underneath was smaller or equal to 5%, assuming we own 5% confidence. Now in the two-sided test, what we'll do is carve out a smaller region on the left, but also one on the right, such that the area on the left doesn't exceed half of 5%, which is 2.5%, and the same for the area on the right. So now we've moved the critical region into two areas. We have a two-sided test now. That's called a two-tailed test. And in totality, the two critical regions on left and right don't exceed 5%. So this looks awfully like a confidence interval, right? So let's flip the coin. In 14 experiments, heads comes up exactly 3 times, and 11 times it comes up tails. Let's do the analysis. So in this table, I've graphed for you the probabilities under the binomial distribution for each possible outcome from 0 to 14, as before. And it goes 0, 0, 0.005, 0.022, 0.06, 0.12, 0.18, 0.21. This is obviously the most likely outcome for the null hypothesis. And then it goes down exactly the way it went up over here. I've also added checkboxes. I want you to check exactly those that define the critical region. So the total probability in the critical region does not exceed 5%. And remember, this is a two-tailed test.